Hi, everybody. I'm Mike.
I'm Matt.
We're armchair directors.
Time to put on a grouchy face.
So with the success of Joker taking a previously happy-go-lucky, fun, boisterous character and what might be the beginning of the DC Dark universe, yeah, series of movies, massive success of Joker, it looks like Sesame Street is following suit. So they just released a new trailer for a movie titled Grouch.
Yeah.
And we're going to do a watch-along here. So if you want to queue it up, we've got it queued up right here. I'm going to give you a countdown. And we've already seen this, but we're going to do like a running, basically a commentary on the trailer. Mm-hmm. You ready?
I'm ready.
3, 2, 1, Grouch.
All right, let's do this.
So visually, it's very similar to Joker.
Uh-huh. And, you know, getting David Harbour was kind of a stroke of genius.
Absolutely.
He just, when I think Oscar the Grouch, that's the guy I go to.
Now, I like this guy they got for Grover. He's, he really, I mean, it's not the Sesame Street we all know and love, but I think right, he captures the spirit of Grover. He's just kind of, he's in the background there, you know, kind of pointing things out, but he's not being a D-bag about it.
And is this going to lead to a Super Grover movie as part of the expanded universe?
Maybe. I mean, you got to wonder how many, like so many cameos. Guy Smiley right here.
Yeah, we got to get a Guy Smiley movie to find out what made him so smiley. I think that would be amazing.
I still can't believe how perfect Harbour is. He looks like he's going to, they're saying that Joaquin Phoenix is, you know, going to get an Oscar for Joker, but I think he might have some competition with Harbour here.
Yeah.
Now this is my least favorite part of the trailer.
Mm-hmm.
They're giving away Ernie getting
big spoiler.
Ernie getting shanked.
Yeah, which is a huge moment. Like, we care about Bert and Ernie so much. To reveal that in the trailer is nuts.
And the guy they got to play Ernie looks fantastic. And I guess blink and you'll miss him. So
yeah.
I don't know. I guess you got to get the butts in seats, right?
Whatever works.
And here's the metamorphosis. Wow.
I've every time I watch Sesame Street, I always wondered, how did Oscar get in that trash can? And finally, somebody is going to answer that.
Well, I've wondered how everybody did everything on Sesame Street. How did Kermit become the roving reporter?
And you know what? Not my Big Bird. Out of everything else I like about this, but that's not my Big Bird. Yeah. They went too far.
And I think having the count strung out, you know, I'm hoping that some of these are redemption stories, like Cookie Monster, you know, he's got to come back from that.
Well, yeah.
I'm so interested to see how this all ties together, and it's such an interesting choice to make Oscar the shatter point. I mean,
right.
Interestingly enough, the shattering of the glass.
Yeah, I would have thought that they would have chosen Big Bird to be like the go-to, but
yeah,
it kind of a bold choice for them to pick Oscar as the jumping point.
And there's Oscar laying down the law.
Wow. Yeah, the acting there. And you know what? Yeah, Scram. That's his classic. You got to have that as the go-to. If he didn't say that, I would be very upset. But I think that they capture kind of the essence of what makes Oscar so special. And some of those other Sesame Street characters, to see this dark side of them, you know, like you said, with the success of Joker, it is now the number one R-rated movie. It surpassed Deadpool today, and Ryan Reynolds was congratulating Joker. But I think Sesame Street Dark is going to be the next one to take the throne.
I think Oscar is going to make Joker look like Sesame Street 80s.
Yeah. And, you know, the Oscar goes to
Oscar the Grouch. How perfect is that going to be?
Yeah. I can't believe they didn't do this sooner, to be honest with you.
Yeah, and that scene at the end of the trailer, just to close this whole discussion of this, where he says, "Can you call me Grouch?" Now, that could come off as, copying Joker, but I think Harbour is so powerful. Mm-hmm. He's doing it better than Joaquin, and I think now in Joker it's kind of ruined. Like, now when I watch Joker and I see Joaquin go, can you introduce me as Joker? That just looks like a lame ripoff of Oscar, even though Oscar is the second one to do it.
Yeah, and it's, you can clearly see that this movie's influenced by that and paying homage
but
to
doing it better, though. Scene.
But yeah, and it's like a Matrix thing where, like, they've taken from other sources and put it together to make something better.
Yeah, it's like how Force Awakens is better than A New Hope in every possible way.
Every possible way.
So that's our thoughts on Grouch. I'm really hoping that this blows the gates open for Sesame Street Dark Universe, because the sky's the limit, and who knows, maybe Disney has been known to make deals with other companies for crossover movies, and maybe we'll get some of those Disney-owned Muppets. Like, I would love to see, like, Kermit come into this and investigate, you know, the crimes of the Grouch. And then just the only question is, who plays Kermit?
Yeah, that I don't know, man. And that's, if that works,
Daniel Day-Lewis.
You
know,
you nailed it. I don't think anybody else could nail Kermit like Daniel Day-Lewis. That would be absolutely amazing.
Or Steve Whitmire. And,
yeah, maybe. He might be too dark.
It's true. So that's our thoughts on Grouch. We want to know your thoughts too. Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and until next time,
enjoy the show.
They're really going dark with this.
They're going for it. Okay. Finally.
They're going for it.